Weeks after Karnataka and Haryana government said that they were considering a legislation against love jihad, the Madhya Pradesh Home Minister Narottam Mishra today has said that the state government would soon bring in a law to counter the problem. A bill may not be brought in the next assembly session to tackle love jihad. This is what Mr. Mishra has said, adding that there will be a provision of 5 years rigorous imprisonment under this new bill. Now, Narottam Mishra spoke with my colleague Anurag Dwari. Let's listen in to what he had to say.
Madhya Pradesh Sarkar ne tay kiya hai ki ab Dharma Swatantra Adhiniyam jo hai 2020 isko sansodhit karke laya jaye 68 wale ko aur usme hum jo bhela kar fusla kar dabav dal kar shaadi kar lete hain इसमें सजा का प्रावधान 5 साल का करें और जो लोग इसमें सहयोगी हो की भूमिका निभाते हैं उनको भी उसी श्रेणी में लाएं, इसे नल एंड वाइड भी करें और नल एंड वाइड के साथ साथ संज्ञेय भी इस अपराध को करना चाहेंगे हम कि ये गैर जमानती अपराध होगा। आप
अगले सत्र में पेश करेंगे?
हाँ, अगले सत्र में ले आएंगे हम इसको विधानसभा।
एक बड़ी बात जो उभर कर सामने आ रही है कि लव जिहाद या इस तरह की बातों को परिभाषित कैसे करेंगे आप?
नहीं, परिभाषित मतलब उसके परिवार के लोग, भाई बंधु, माता पिता अगर रिपोर्ट डालते हैं इस तरह की तो उसको करेंगे, और अगर वो कोई करना भी चाहता है इस तरह से तो उसे कलेक्टर से अनुमति लेना पड़ेगी, 1 महीने पहले आवेदन देना पड़ेगा।
ऐसा तो नहीं है कि जिस तरह से आरोप लग रहे हैं कि अब आप लोग हिंदू वोटों के ध्रुवीकरण के लिए या एक हिंदू राष्ट्र के निर्माण के लिए ऐसी बातों को आगे लेकर जा रहे हैं जिसका बहुत ज़्यादा आधार नहीं है, ये समाज में बहुत ही मतलब कह लीजिए कि 0.0% भी नहीं।
ये कुछ वर्ग है एक ऐसा जो असहिष्णु जैसे शब्द लेके आता है, जो इस तरह के शब्द लाता है वो एक वर्ग है जो इस तरह की बातें करता है, पर ये सामाजिक कुरीति है। ये जगह जगह लगातार शिकायतें आ रही हैं और बाद में हमारी बेटियाँ परेशान होती रहती हैं, ये कतई बर्दाश्त करने वाली बात
नहीं। मध्य प्रदेश में तो बहुत कम मामले आए हैं, इसको
जितने भी आए हों एक भी नहीं आना चाहिए, एक भी बेटी परेशान नहीं होना चाहिए।
पर ये आप नहीं मानते कि सिर्फ मतलब हिंदुओं के वोटों के लिए ये किया जा रहा है?
वोट के लिए हम कुछ भी नहीं करते हैं भाई, वोटों के लिए कभी कुछ नहीं किया। भारतीय जनता पार्टी, मैंने कहा ना, कुरीतियों को मेटने की काम की, वोटों के लिए करते तो क्या उस समय कोई चुनाव थे क्या, ट्रिपल तलाक, राम जन्म भूमि वगैरह जो किए, कोई चुनाव नहीं था, लेकिन वादा था, एजेंडे में था, हमारे घोषणा पत्र में था, किया। कांग्रेस की तरह झूठ नहीं बोलते हम, ना कांग्रेस की तरह आपको हम कोई वो करते हैं। अभी पूरी दिवाली पे आपने कहीं दीपावली की पूजा करते राहुल गांधी या उनके परिवार का फोटो देखा, कहीं आपने गोवर्धन पूजा करते उनको देखा, वो सिर्फ चुनाव में मंदिर जाते हैं।
आप आश्वस्त करेंगे प्रदेशवासियों को कि किसी धर्म विशेष को टारगेट नहीं किया जाएगा?
किसी को टारगेट नहीं किया जाता है, जो कानून है उस कानून के सम्मत काम होगा।
अगर कोई हिंदू लड़का भी किसी दूसरे धर्म की लड़की
को भी टारगेट नहीं किया जाएगा।
All right, and Anurag Dwari now joins us. Anurag, you know, you've asked very direct questions to the Madhya Pradesh Home Minister, but they are, you know, they're pretty keen on bringing about this legislation. It's interesting because the Home Ministry has in the past pretty categorically said that they have no documented cases of love jihad.
Yes, and I think in February this year, in a written reply, the Home Ministry has clearly said that no cases of love jihad by any of the central agencies. But in Madhya Pradesh, moving ahead of Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan's announcement to make law against love jihad, Home Minister Narottam Mishra has said that the government will bring a bill to counter the problem in the next assembly session. And very cleverly, he just said that, you guys coined such terms as love jihad. And he also said that there'll be a provision of rigorous imprisonment up to 5 years in the bill. And this will come under the Dharma Swatantra Vidheyak 2020 in the coming session of the assembly. And it'll have rigorous imprisonment up to 5 years on forcible marriage and forced conversions. Rishika?
All right, Anurag, appreciate you joining us with the very latest. Madhya Pradesh to bring a bill against the so-called love jihad. The Madhya Pradesh Home Minister there speaking with Anurag Dwari has said that this is a problem that needs to be addressed. The question that we're asking is, with such little evidence of documented cases of love jihad, is this then a bid to criminalize interfaith marriage? Well, we have with us Neha Bagga, the spokesperson of the BJP. We also have Dr. Dharmendra Bajpai, spokesperson of the Congress in Madhya Pradesh, both joining us. Thank you both very much for speaking with NDTV. Neha, I want to begin by asking you, Given the fact that there are no registered cases or evidence, so to speak, of love jihad, the Home Ministry has in Parliament clarified that there are no documented cases. What is really the rationale of your government to do this?
Rushika, Home Minister has made it clear that we don't want even a single case to get registered. And therefore, as a precaution, as these cases are increasing day by day, we are coming up with this law of love jihad, in which there is a 5-year imprisonment. Whoever, gets married forcibly, forced a girl to convert her religion. And we have seen plenty of cases across India that many girls are forcefully married, and they are treated like sex slaves after marriage. And a lot of problems they have faced after getting into this trap. So whoever is indulged in love jihad thing, whoever supports love jihad, against them, these cases will be registered. And
if I can just ask you a follow-up question, Neha, I think that, you're perhaps right in saying that, women are tortured, subject to all kinds of abuse, a lot of times trapped in bad marriages. Shouldn't then we perhaps be looking to push for laws against marital rape, talk about issues that really concern women, maybe makes more stringent laws against sexual abuse instead of communalizing crime against women?
Rushika, there are love jihad cases, and that is why we are focusing. That is why
Madhya Pradesh
government
is serious
on love jihad. But where
are these cases? Because they don't seem to have been registered anywhere.
No, who says that there's no registered cases?
The Home Ministry.
You can always find the registered. See, you can always see all these kind of scenario. Mm-hmm. 1,000 crores are spent on these love jihad cases to push karne ke liye. A lot of money is put in, 1,000 crores, and there are enough evidential proofs across the country. Therefore, Madhya Pradesh has taken one step ahead, bringing this law in Parliament in Vidhan Sabha 2020, so that if any such matter comes around, the government can take strict action.
Just clarify for the benefit of our viewers, Neha. One side you are saying that these cases exist, and these are love jihad is real. On the other side, you are saying that you are bringing up about a law in order to make sure that this doesn't happen. The question here is very simple. Is there a communal colour that is being given to interfaith marriage? Is this a bid to criminalise interfaith marriage? Because look at the flip side of it. I mean, this is a potentially dangerous law that can really be misused.
Rushika, there's nothing dangerous in law. Dangerous is how girls are converted forcibly. How girls are converted on the name of love, and then jihad begins.
What happens when minor girls
are sexually abused on the name of this love jihad, and it is more dangerous when you ruin a girl's life after marriage. Ek tilak laga ke ladka aata, and then after marriage he forces you to convert into his religion. This is more dangerous, and therefore
isn't this very subjective? Because it's literally he said versus she said, right? I mean, how does the law determine whether someone has been forcefully converted or not? There have been cases where people have called it love jihad, where both the parties involved in the case have actually come out and said that no, we weren't forced to convert, etc. My question to you is it going to become extremely difficult if this law comes into place? And it's not just Madhya Pradesh, it's even Karnataka and Haryana that are talking about a law like this. Is it just going to become extremely difficult for interfaith marriage to take place if a law like this is brought into place? What's your assessment?
Rushika, it's very simple. See, anybody is free to get married to whomsoever they want to. But if you want to get married to a Hindu girl or a Muslim guy, you can always go to a special marriage act. And if you're not doing that, if you are pretending to be someone else, and after marriage, you force a girl to convert her religion to Muslim, then that's the dangerous thing. Then that's the real problem where it begins.
But what and if the girl wants to voluntarily do it? Then what happens?
Tolerated in Madhya Pradesh. If girls want to voluntarily go and get married to a Muslim guy, she can always do that. But before that, 1 month prior, they need to apply for it. All the investigation part, all the things will be done from the government part, and then they can get married. And again, we have.
So you're saying no. So 1 second. Let me just get this straight. You're saying that if two consenting adults want to get married, but they belong to different faiths, they need the permission of the state to effectively do so. That's what you're saying.
They need to apply.
And that permission then is the prerogative of the state.
As Home Minister has made it clear that they need to apply a month prior to that.
Okay.
Then they can get married because a lot of cases
come after marriage. So two consenting adults belonging to different faiths essentially need the permission of the state if this law comes into place to get married. Anuj Atre of the Congress also with us. Anuj Atre, do you want to respond to this new law that is being mulled by the Madhya Pradesh government right now?
See, this BJP government, not only in Madhya Pradesh, they all over India, wherever they are in, they have been trying to disturb the peace and harmony of our country. ये लोगों का एक motive रहा है जब से ये लोग center आए हैं और districts में रहे हैं. अब ये love jihad का ये this word why has not emerged before 2014? ये 2014 के बाद से एक love jihad का एक नया एक word उभर के आया है. Otherwise क्या हमारा constitution क्या हमारा
so are you saying that this love jihad is a creation of the BJP for political gains? Is that the allegation
exactly,
that you're making?
Exactly. देखिए हमारा constitution allow every citizen to follow their religion. ठीक है आप born you may be born in any family with who follow any religion, but when you get adult you are free to follow any religion and you are free to two people are adult and they are free to get married to anybody.
Right.
But इसको एक communal color दिया जा रहा है. Communal color देने के साथ साथ कहीं ना कहीं जो है एक country का जो एक माहौल disturb करने की एक कोशिश है. ये सब उसी का ही एक this is a part of it. Instead of maintaining law and order, उसी को control करने के लिए, disturb करने के लिए कहीं ना कहीं इस चीज को और एक बढ़ावा देने के लिए कहीं.
Okay. I think I have to, it's only fair that I get Neha Bagga to respond to that. Neha Bagga, the allegation that is being leveled by the Congress is that you're giving communal color or legitimacy, to this entire concept of love jihad, which like, you know, many have said, doesn't really exist. It's a creation to foment communal tensions and your government is essentially giving legitimacy to that.
Rishika, with due respect to Atre ji, आपको शायद जानकारी नहीं होगी, लव जिहाद का टर्म जो है ये भाजपा का दिया हुआ नहीं है. 2009 में जब केरला में क्रिश्चियन और हिंदुओं लड़कियों को कन्वर्ट करने के लिए उन्हें किडनैप करके एक तरीके से रखा गया था, बंदी बनाकर, जब ये केस कोर्ट में गया था तो वहां के जो जज हैं उन्होंने इसे लव जिहाद का नाम दिया था. ये पहली बार नाम वहां से सुना गया था. और अगर हिंदू लड़कियों को प्रताड़ित किया जाता है शादी के बाद, अभी हाल ही का एक ताजा मामला है जो निकिता को गोली मारी गई थी.
नेहा, ये अभी ताजा आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क यू, आप कह रहे हैं नेहा, आप कह रहे हैं हिंदू लड़कियों को प्रताड़ित किया जाता है. आई एम श्योर इट्स नॉट जस्ट हिंदू विमेन, बट इट्स विमेन कटिंग अक्रॉस सेक्शंस हु आर सब्जेक्ट टू द वर्स्ट काइंड ऑफ
ऑल अबाउट कन्वर्जन. Rishika, we cannot generalize the issue.
But you're talking specifically about women who are abused after they get married. My question to you is very simple. Do you believe only women of one community are abused after they get married? What about women from other communities?
Rishika, we cannot generalize the issue. It's matter of love jihad. It's matter of post conversion, and therefore I am making it clear. जहां पर भी ये सफल नहीं होते हैं वहां लड़की को गोली मार देते हैं. हाल ही का निकिता का केस सामने आया था एंड प्लेंटी ऑफ केसेस वी हैव सीन इन यूपी, इन केरला एंड लॉट ऑफ केसेस वेयर गर्ल्स आर कन्वर्टेड टू मुस्लिम रिलीजन जस्ट फॉर द कन्वर्जन सेक.
वेल यू
हैड दीस गर्ल्स आर टॉर्चर्ड, दीस गर्ल्स आर अब्यूज्ड, दीस गर्ल्स आर ट्रीटेड एज सेक्स.
वेल आर गर्ल्स ओनली ऑफ वन कम्युनिटी बीइंग टॉर्चर्ड? आई थिंक दैट्स रियली फूड फॉर थॉट हियर. And does the government perhaps need to take a more holistic view of this? Does the government perhaps need to take a more holistic view of this and not give it this communal colour? It's an interesting conversation, and thank you both very much, Anuja Athreya and Neha Bagga, for joining us on the broadcast.